In 2003, Oklahoma State University started the Okanola Project. Its goal was to introduce winter canola as a rotation crop for winter wheat in Oklahoma. Well, as with any new crop, producers and researchers had a lot to learn. Here is a review of this season and where canola stands in Oklahoma 6 years later. This is what canola fields look like now since harvest has come to a close. The season got off to a great start in the fall, with soil moistures being right where they should be. But with the ever-changing weather in Oklahoma, it didn't stay that way. Winter canola extension assistant Heath Sanders has spent the season observing the progress.
As we progressed through the fall and into the winter, it became very dry and continued to stay dry till early spring. So a lot of the canola had a lot of drought stress on it.
The only moisture the fields even got to see was when Oklahoma was hit by freezes in early spring.
The freezes we did lose yield potential due to the freeze. And winter canola has the ability to, you know, whenever it does have a freeze that shuts down that crop, has the ability to branch out, put on new branches and flower and put on pods and continue to try to make a crop with what it has.
And because of that, some producers new to canola were impressed with how well it held up.
Out of the way this year has been, from the dry weather to the freezes, they were just surprised that the winter canola was still putting on a crop and still going to make a crop.
Harvest went well. Farmers haven't had to deal with a lot of rain and muddy fields, so pushing and swathing have not been a problem, and they have been able to get their crop out of the ground.
Now, I haven't got in all the reports, but what I've been hearing, you know, anywhere's from 14 bushels an acre to 45 bushels an acre, depending on where you're at, what varieties you had, and how that crop was able to go ahead and finish what it was doing with the amount of time that it had.